Picture it. You're in a little boat with your companions and a teacher that you have been following for some time now. He says things from time to time that confuse you, but you know that his message is important, so you follow, and you do as he suggests. And here you are in this little boat with him, when all of a sudden, out of nowhere, comes the most horrible storm you have ever seen. The wind is whipping all about, and the waves are coming up into the boat. There's water everywhere. It's raining and thundering and lightning. It's like the end of the world. And you're frightened and cold and quite wet. But there you are, in the middle of all this tumult, frightened half to death. And you look to your teacher. Where is he? Oh, he's over there asleep. What nerve! You would at least think he'd have the common decency to be cringing in fear along with the rest of you, but no! He's sleeping. Through all of this. Who could sleep through this storm? You wake him up. And he's groggy and looks up at you and you say, dude, it's storming out here. There's water in the boat. We're drowning. We're all gonna die. Don't you care? What's wrong with you? Uh-oh, here comes another wave. That was close. What is your teacher doing? He's just sitting there. He's the picture of calm. If he shows any emotion at all, it's maybe a slight bit of annoyance. Is he annoyed at the weather? Is he annoyed at the wind and the waves? Is he annoyed at being wet and cold? No! He's annoyed at you for waking him up. Go figure. He sighs, lifts up his hand, knock it off! Peace! Enough already! Oy vey! And all of a sudden, just as quickly as it had come up, there is peace. The wind dies down. The sea becomes glassy and calm. The clouds part, and the warmth and the light of the sun pours through, and suddenly it's a beautiful day again. Ta-da! And your teacher looks at you and can't believe that you would have doubted. But there you are. Are you grateful? Do you thank him? No, you look at yourself, you look at each other, at your companions, and you go, who is this? The wind and the waves obey him. Who is he that he can control nature itself? And if you weren't scared during the storm, boy, are you scared? with that big, scary animal, obscuring faith. I'm sure that all of us have had those experiences. We have all witnessed the presence of the big, scary animal known as fear. The big, scary animal is greedy. It devours trust. It obscures faith. It intimidates. It paralyzes us into inaction. It lies to us and tells us that change is not good, that nothing we will do will succeed, that there never was hope, there is no hope now, and never will be. The big, scary animal lies. We talk about facing reality. And our reality as a congregation is that we are a small group of people of dwindling numbers, buffeted about by the tumult of the world, the winds of change, and the seas of doubt. And we tell ourselves, we have to face reality. But I would ask you, who created reality? It wasn't you, it wasn't me, so who created it? The answer is God. God created our reality. It is God who shapes reality. God who can change it at will. For because God created it, God is stronger than reality. And God is stronger than the big, scary animal we call fear. But before we find ourselves able to have faith, we need to banish that big, scary animal that tells us that change is not good, that failure is inevitable, that hope is impossible to find. Because that's not reality. Those are lies. We as individuals and as a whole need to banish the big scary animal from our midst. No big scary animals allowed. We need to vow that we will no longer listen to and be intimidated by that big scary animal called fear, choosing instead to follow the path of the Lamb of God, who calms storms and who, through God's power, changes reality. The Lamb of God awaits us. And so does a future for this church as we follow the Savior who calms storms and forgives sins into the light of grace as beacon.